What's up, YouTube? I would like to officially welcome you to Hollywood. Of course, they're here promoting the one and only Birds of Prey.
This is at Hollywood and Highland.
Woo! I just got some free stuff from that booth over there. I got a poster, I got some pins. Probably gonna wear these in my review.
And check it out. Costumes from the film. We got Harley Quinn. We got Harley Quinn again. We got that black mask. Who's that, Huntress? Black Canary? I don't know who that is. It's hot topic.
They also have photo booths. I think I might get a picture on Harley's broken car there.
Birds of Prey!
The movie trap!
Alright, I think we've seen enough. Let's talk about this movie.
Birds of Prey, and the Fantabulous Emancipation of one Harley Quinn. So Birds of Prey is the 8th movie in the DC Extended Universe. Yes, it is in fact rated R. It follows the adventures of Miss Harley Quinn, once again played by Margot Robbie. Whether you liked Suicide Squad or not, the general consensus on her is that she was great in that movie. But now, a few years later, she and the Joker have broken up. They have gone their separate ways. Harley Quinn is on a quest to claim her independence, and she gets wrapped up in kind of a gangster mafia kind of story. Young Cassandra Cain has stolen a diamond from Roman Sionis and Victor Zsasz, so now Harley Quinn and a few other badass women are going to team up to protect her. And now we have our movie that I've been looking forward to, in case you couldn't tell. And just in case you're new to my channel, I am that guy who liked Suicide Squad. I'm not ashamed to admit it. I watched it again the other night, and I do definitely see some problems with it for sure. It's not a perfect movie by any means, but honestly for me, the good in that movie outweighs the bad. The reason I'm mentioning this is because this movie, Birds of Prey, does mention the events of Suicide Squad at some points. I do feel like it's fair to say that. So yeah, Suicide Squad haters, that movie did actually happen. They didn't just write it out of DCEU lore. This movie does kind of have that same chaotic vibe that Suicide Squad had, but it's just more focused on Harley Quinn. She's still the same character she was in Suicide Squad, which is great. And yeah, Margot Robbie still completely crushes it as Harley Quinn. This is Margot Robbie's movie. She produced it as well as starred in it, and she did have to fight for that R rating. And she narrates this movie too, which is a lot of fun. But as for the other characters, you know, it's not just Harley Quinn's movie. The Birds of Prey team itself, the other members are Cassandra Cain, Renee Montoya, Black Canary, and the Huntress. The standouts to me were, first of all, Black Canary, aka Dinah Lance, played by Journey Smollett-Bell. I thought she was a pretty badass Black Canary. But also Cassandra Cain, played by Ella J. Basco. She's like 13 years old, but she does hold her own verbally against all these older women. She has banter back and forth with Harley Quinn. You know, par for the course with fun action movie. Now, Mary Elizabeth Winstead as the Huntress, I still think she's really good casting, and her action scenes were really cool. You know, I love her motorcycle and her crossbow and her getup. But the character herself, I honestly gotta say, didn't impress me too much. I mean, the movie kind of builds her up, but then they decide to go more comedic with it, and I was like, oh, okay, well, wasn't expecting that. I mean, it's a really slight nitpick, though. And Rosie Perez as Renee Montoya. She was badass, too. Although I didn't care too much for her backstory, either. The main villain in this movie is Ewan McGregor as Roman Sionis. Sionis, I usually know it as, but in this movie, they say Sionis, aka Black Mask. And I gotta say, I thought Ewan McGregor crushed it. I thought Black Mask was actually a pretty memorable villain because of the way he acted. You know, he was pretty flamboyant. I could just tell that Ewan McGregor had a really good time shooting this movie. And I can't really think of any other villain in any other movie that I've seen that is like Black Mask in this movie. So props to Ewan McGregor. And yeah, I did enjoy this movie a lot, but I did have some minor problems. The editing in the first act of the movie was kind of choppy because it's doing a couple things. It's establishing backstories for the main characters, and it's also setting up the plot of the movie. But it's all being narrated by Harley Quinn, so the way she tells the story is chaotic, which makes sense because it's Harley Quinn. She's kind of crazy. Well, very crazy. Like, the story's going along, and then Harley Quinn will be like, wait a minute, let me tell you about these characters and how they fit into the story. So it flashes back, and so the scenes are kind of out of order in kind of a Pulp Fiction-y kind of way. I kind of want to see a cut of this movie where all the scenes are in order, because I honestly had a hard time keeping up with it. Also, this movie is rushed. It's less than 2 hours long. It's like an hour 50. I always say any live-action, big-budget movie that's less than 2 hours is gonna feel rushed. And sure enough, this movie does, but again, the fact that, like, they're going through so chaotic, it's all part of the stylisticness of it. This movie is stylistic. Undeniably so. But not in the same way as Suicide Squad. I'm not gonna go into detail, just you're gonna have to see for yourself. But yeah, in case I haven't said it enough times already, this movie's chaotic. And in that, this movie's also ridiculous. Yes, it's absurd. The action does get very zany and over the top, and at some points even kind of cartoonish. You know, you saw in the trailer Harley has a pet hyena in this movie. There's a scene where she walks in and she's shooting guys with like a confetti gun. Although that action scene in particular was pretty cool. You know, it goes slow-mo. In fact, now that I think about it, the action in this movie was all around really cool. I mean, the Birds of Prey team, for the most part, they don't have superpowers. They just beat the shit out of goons. But it's their banter, the chemistry that they have during the action scenes that made them entertaining. Good stuff. You know, there were comedic moments during the action scenes. And I'd heard from early reviews that this movie is like super violent and gory. Honestly, I wouldn't say this movie is all that gory. Maybe pretty violent, sure. But I mean, Joker was way gorier than this. I mean, of course, there were some points during the action scenes where I was like, ooh, oh, that's brutal. But it wasn't because of anything gory. It would be like because of a hit, you know, like Harley Quinn kicks someone in the knee and it bends it the wrong way. You're just like, ooh. Which I guess is enough violence-wise to justify the R rating. A lot of F-bombs in this movie too, of course. And like I predicted, this movie didn't really hit me in the feels. There were some surprisingly deep moments though. Like with the characters whose backstories I did care about, I was like, oh, wow, okay, that's good. And with Harley Quinn herself. I was like, huh, I didn't see that surprisingly deep moment coming. So yeah, again, good job, Birds of Prey. Now, when it comes to the music in this film, of course, this is one of those movies that's more about the soundtrack than the score, because the score in this movie done by Daniel Pemberton is like nothing. I heard he wrote a Harley theme, but I couldn't make it out, because the soundtrack in this movie is boss. And depending on if you like the genre of music, you know, EDM, because that's mostly what it is, there are some good tracks on there. That one Doja Cat song in particular, Boss Bitch, that is a bop. Just saying. So yeah, in the end, Birds of Prey and the Fantabulous Emancipation of One Harley Quinn is pretty much what I thought it would be. It's a fun movie, you'll have a good time with it. The vibe and the atmosphere is crazy, zany, over the top, stylistic, and that is the star of this movie. I still love Margot Robbie as Harley Quinn. I like all the other characters. Some of the backstories I liked, some of the others, maybe not so much. The editing in the first act I felt was a little choppy, but that's the biggest glaring issue I have with this movie. The humor I thought was really funny. I genuinely did laugh out loud quite a few times here. The action was kick-ass, and the music was bop. For Birds of Prey and the Fantabulous Emancipation of One Harley Quinn, I will say, go see this movie while it's in theaters. Just again, this movie's rated R, so don't bring your kids. The screening I went to, I saw some people bringing their like little 4-year-old kids. I'm like, why are you bringing them to this rated R movie? Are you trying to scar them for life? I don't know. So, Birds of Prey and the Fantabulous Emancipation of One Harley Quinn. Have you seen it? What did you think about it? Whatever you think, go ahead and leave a comment. And don't forget to subscribe.